Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to discuss about Post Office Savings Bank account and how to complete the application form to open the account. You can visit indiapost.gov.in to know more details about savings bank account. As you can see, the interest rate payable is 4% per annum and the minimum balance that needs to be maintained is 20 rupees. So account can be opened only by cash, and the minimum balance that has to be maintained with non-check facility is 50 rupees. So if you are going to opt for checkbook, then you have to maintain 500 rupees as a minimum balance. Then if you have opened the account without checkbook facility, you can opt for that in the later time as well. So the interest earned on the savings bank account is tax-free up to 10,000 rupees. So account can also be transferred from one post office to another in case you are moving from one place to another. You have a facility to transfer your account as well. So you have option to open account for your kids as well who are who have completed 10 years, and you can also open a joint account up to 3 people. So single account, in case you open as a single account, that can be converted to joint account in a later time. So let's see what are the documents required to open the account. So one is the duly completed application form, which we are going to discuss in few more minutes. And ID proof like Aadhaar card, voter ID, driving license, ration card, etc. And address proof, you can use electricity bill, ration card, bank passport, etc. So if you have a Aadhaar card that has your photo as well as address proof, you can use your Aadhaar for both the purposes. And you need to submit two passport size photographs. In case the account opening is for minors, then the guardian has to submit two more photographs to open the account. The application can be collected from nearest post office, or you can also download from the link given below. Friends, now let's see how to complete the application form. So this is the first page. As you can see, the box which is marked in red, you have to leave it blank because it is only used by post office officials. So to start with, you have to mention which type of account you want to open, since this application form can be used for savings bank as well as recurring deposit as well as NSC certificate. So multiple purpose, multiple types of accounts can be used using the same application form. Since I am going to open a savings bank account, I mentioned savings bank. So you can also mention if you need a checkbook. So you can mention the same here. Then you have to mention your details. So Mr. on the name, first name, last name, and your surname here, and gender. Then here you have to mention your father, husband, mother, etc. So here I have mentioned my father name. Here you have to provide your complete address details, and telephone number and email are optional. And if the account opening is for a joint, like you are opening the account for multiple people, then you have to fill up details for other applicants as well. So in the application, wherever you see the star marks, those fields are mandatory. You have to complete those fields. So here you have to complete with the applicant's date of birth details and the PAN number. So again, if it is a joint account, you have to mention details about all the people. So operating instructions, you have to mention who can operate this account. Since I'm opening a single, I mentioned single or self. So if it is a joint, then you can mention details here. And you have to provide your KYC documents. So here I am providing a PAN card and Aadhaar. So you need to mention the PAN number and Aadhaar number details here in these boxes. So the first deposit amount you have to mention, as we discussed. So you can start your account as low as 50 rupees, but you can, if you want to deposit more at the time of opening the account, you can mention those details here in this box. And nominee details. So in case some unfortunate thing happen with the applicant, then you have to mention the details about the nominee who will be eligible to receive those amount, which is in this savings bank account. So you can have more than one nominee mentioned in the application. So you have to mention or split the share accordingly. Since I have mentioned only one nominee name, I mentioned 100% here, and you have to fill up the complete address details of your nominee. So coming to second page of your application, so you need to fill in your Aadhaar number here, the way you filled in first page, you have to mention again. And point number 11, 12, 13 needs to be filled in only if you are taking or opening account for minors. So you have to mention your guardian details, and or even these fields are mandatory if you are opening account for physically challenged people as well. Point number 14, if at all you are going to open recurring deposit account as well, and if you want your the money to be deducted from this savings account, you have to mention those numbers here. Point number 215, 18 are applicable only if you are giving authorization to an agent to operate your account or to withdraw money from the account. So otherwise you can leave them blank. So you have to mention date and signature here. Fill in your photograph. If it is joint account, you have to provide photograph of all the applicants. So if the account is for minors, then you have to affix photographs of both minor as well as guardian. And this last section you can leave it blank, because this is again only for office use. This is the last page of the application form. So this is about the KYC details. So you have to provide the applicant name, signature, and the photo. Similarly for all the applicants who will be part of this application. And then you have to provide complete details of the applicant name, address you have to provide, and then the document details which you are submitting as for ID and address proof, those details have to be mentioned here, and you need to sign it. That's it, friends. This is very simple and straightforward process. Thank you for very much for watching this.